I'm really happy to be part of the meeting of the Asian Farmers Forum, which is happening right now. I really am privileged to be part of this. I just want to recognize that coming from the African continent, the idea of family farming is something that we relate to very well. A significant proportion of our population here is farming, so we definitely understand many of the challenges we are talking about, and we recognize the opportunities that farming brings. For example, here on our continent, 64% of the food that is eaten in our cities comes from our family farmers. Only 10% of the food that farmers produce is eaten on the farm. 90% is eaten somewhere else. So our farmers are ensuring our food, they're ensuring our nutrition, and they are part of ensuring that we get fed, but they're also contributing significantly to SDGs. So I just wanted really to make sure that we very much understand the place and role of our farmers as we go into this work. The Asian farmers as well have a significant share of their contribution to our food systems, but are also having challenges like the previous speaker just said. Many of the challenges have to do with land. Many of the challenges have to do with access to technologies and all the things we know that we need to be addressing. The Food Systems Summit recognizes all this, but also recognizes the opportunity that is built in the UN Decade for Family Farming. And I wanted to link the UN Decade for Family Farming with the work we are doing in the Food Systems Summit, where we see the opportunity to ensure that all the farmers' platform find their voice and the opportunity to engage in the Food Systems Summit. So as you would know, Esther, who is your Secretary General, is a member of our advisory committee. Elizabeth, who is the chair of the Pan-African Farmers Forum, is a member of our advisory committee, and a number of others, whether it is Ajay in India, Ismail here on the African continent, and all the way to Tio Diego, who is the president of the World Farmers Association. We are trying to make sure that we find these are champions in the summit. We are trying to make sure that we create opportunity and room for you all to be able to engage. I just wanted to reassure you that during this summit, we really plan to put farmers' voice forward and to give you an opportunity to engage. The summit gives us an opportunity also to respond to a number of challenges. It gives us an opportunity to be part of the Decade of Action. One of the reasons the summit was launched is recognizing that we are off track in a number of SDGs and we only have 10 years to come through. So the summit does provide that opportunity. But also the food system. Our food system, many of the people say some of the challenges we have associated with our food system because it's contributing to climate change, it's contributing to biodiversity loss. But it's also a solution. And from a farmer's perspective, I completely relate to that. It is a solution to many of the problems we have. And our farmers, through farming and doing it well, provide an opportunity to be able for us to be able to answer the issue that the Secretary General raised and the opportunity he saw in farming when he says we can actually build back better. We can use our food system to build back better. And I wanted to emphasize that point. The summit will focus on 5 objectives, which we see as the key challenges of our food systems. It will focus on ensuring access to safe and nutritious food, which is part of what you, from a farmer's perspective, would all be concerned about. You want to make sure that your children have safe food. You want to make sure that they have nutritious food. But you're also part of ensuring that the world has access to that. We also will focus on shifting to sustainable consumption. This part recognizes that the way we produce food is part of the problem, that the food we eat does actually sometimes present challenges. The way it is processed, the way it is consumed does present challenges. So really ensuring that we are working on consumption, but also on waste is part of what the Food System Summit will look at. Then we talk about boosting nature-positive production, which recognizes that the way we produce food does contribute to emissions, does contribute to climate change to some extent. So it's important that we think of ways of producing food that reduces our ability to contribute to climate change. So this number 3 recognizes that we can actually be part of solving the problem of contributing to climate change. Number 4 recognizes that we have a lot of challenges within our systems. We have a lot of vulnerabilities. We don't have enough jobs. We have a lot of young people that need jobs. We need to raise incomes and ensure that there's better inclusion, that we are reaching all the people that need to be reached, that we are improving equitable livelihoods. And number 5 recognizes that in the face of climate change, we do need to build more resilience. We do need to ensure that the shocks and stresses we are facing are not impacting the weakest among us the most, but also that our systems are a little bit more resilient than they have been. So these five objectives really will be the focus of the summit in what is called action tracks. So the next slide really looks at what would we be looking to achieve in the summit? What are we looking to do? The summit does recognize that you all have negotiated so many agreements. We have CFS, which is our leader in all these negotiations, which is putting out very great negotiated ground out there. We have the SDGs that have already been negotiated and the documents that are out there, pieces of work that we need to come through on. So we are not looking to negotiate new ground with this summit. What we are looking to do is to elevate the conversation around food systems, to understand what is wrong with our food systems and to understand what we need to do differently to ensure that our food systems can help us come through on some of the challenges we face. So really here we are talking about raising public awareness, ensuring that we are all aware of the problems, but also the solutions. The second thing is we need to ensure that we can commit to action. That once we understand what is broken, once we understand what the challenges are, we can actually commit to action and be able to elevate our action so that we have the opportunity to come through in 2030. As you would know, on hunger, for example, or even nutrition, we are not yet there. And if we are going to get to these actions, we have to elevate our ambition for action. We have to be able to come up with clear actions that can set us on a better path than we are currently on. Part of the outcomes of this summit would call to action to ensure that all of us are committing to action. We'll also ensure that we have a system of follow-up. We do have the SDGs. We do have commitments we want to make through this forum, but we also want to make sure that we are committing to following up and ensuring that we come in the remaining decade, what the SDG has called the decade of action. So the summit really is about ensuring that we build consensus in a good way. We all come together and work with you all. But to be able to do that, we must engage all of you. There are different forums which we have been engaging in. And with the summit, we have an additional opportunity to engage. We must engage all of you. So for us, it's an opportunity to reach out to people all over the world. That's why I'm talking to you now. It's an opportunity to reach out to people. It's an opportunity to engage people we haven't engaged before. I'm hoping that by engaging Esther, who is your leader in the summit, we are engaging you directly. We are hearing your voices. But also, we are going to provide other opportunities through the champions, through the dialogues. We have country-level dialogues that I'm going to talk about. And hopefully, you can engage and feel like this is something that is engaging you personally. So the summit has to reach out to as many people as we can here. The challenges here, also here, the opportunities, and think through together how we can go forward. So we are looking at this as a people's summit, but also we are looking at it as a solutions summit, a summit that really focuses on helping us get the solutions to the challenges we are living with and get that solution that will allow us to transition our food system from the current food system, which has a number of challenges, to a future food system. So a new food system that really tries to deal with some of those challenges and recognizes that we have to live alongside our planet. We need our planet to be able to live. So the solutions we are looking for, a solution that will take us to better health for people, but also better health for the planet. So the summit has a number of work streams. I've mentioned a number of those. It talked about action tracks, which is going to be the place where we come up with all these ideas that help us address some of the challenges we are talking about. But also it has a scientific group that is looking at the evidence that is needed for us to be very comfortable and very sure that where we are going is where we should go. So what we should be doing really need to be anchored in evidence. The summit also has dialogues. These dialogues are going to happen at country level. If there's one thing you need to remember from what I have said, I need you to remember that these dialogues are the most important place. Engage with the dialogues when they happen. Make sure your voice is heard. Make sure your solutions are heard. And make sure you bring everybody into these dialogues. We are launching a global campaign next week, starting with the World Food Week. And that campaign is to ensure that in every country, we have a dialogue. In every country, we engage each and every one of you. So the opportunity here is for you to engage and make sure that when this food system summit does happen, it actually does represent your views, your challenges, and the opportunities that you see as we go into the summit, your hopes and dreams. So please, if there was one thing you would do as a farmer, as a farming community, engage in the dialogues and make sure that they represent your views and ideas. The most important thing is engage in the dialogues that we are launching next week. They will last for 6 months. Make sure you're heard. Make sure your voice is out there. Thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you.
Mabuhay ang pamilyang magsasaka.